Good morning. This is Dr. Klumber with Project High Rise. This is the first episode, although technically it's the last episode, or is that the other way around? And what I've done is I wanted to start this Let's Play with the final product, or at least close to the final product, because I want to use it as a tips and tricks video to show you how you get certain things done and not done. And then offer you the opportunity to see the whole Let's Play, maybe get some more insight in certain decisions that I've made following on from this. So let's go and start with the elevator. Look, elevator right there. And it's got funky music. I don't know if you can hear that. Yeah, elevator waiting music. What more do we want? So yeah, Project High-Rise. It's a very cool game. I really like it. As many commenters on YouTube have said, it's a lot like SimTower, modern version. And generally, I just really like playing this. I've had it for a couple of days because it's only been out to Joe Public for a few days. And I really want to get my hands on this after I saw other people play it, because it looks like it's a good in-depth proper simulator. I really like the art style. As you can see here, we're really zoomed in. This is the closest you can zoom in. And the game just looks good. It just looks good. It still looks like it could be 10 years old, but then with a bit more swagger and a bit more style. Yeah, the issue I have, unfortunately, with OBS recording on the Mac is that my mouse isn't actually captured. But that doesn't matter. What we have here is the bottom floor of my building. And I'm going to talk about tips and tricks, and I wanted to start off with this sort of image, because I don't want to reveal the whole building in one go. In fact, I can't. Even if I zoom out all the way, I can't. But we will start all the way to the left, and there we go. This bit here is my shopping tower, and this is the most left building, if you like, in my build. And the reason for that, this is the first tip I suppose, is you want your different sections separated, because each unit produces either noise or a smell, and it also produces traffic. Some things really like traffic, like shops. Other things don't like traffic, like posh apartments. So it makes a lot of sense to separate things, and I've kept this in mind when I planned out my whole build. The second thing I will say is this map, you can't see it obviously now, but this is the very large map, or whatever it's called, at the beginning of the game. And there is a reason for that, and I will get to that reason now. So this is the shopping tower, this is my entrance lobby, nothing spectacular, I've even got a little plaza. And then the second tower is my restaurant tower. So this is just all restaurants, they're all reasonably happy, they all seem to be making a bit of a profit. And they are all in a high traffic area. If you look at the top right, you can see how they feel about things. We like being in a high traffic area. Why are they in a high traffic area? Because they're right on the elevator, and people will actually take the lift one floor down to get to the, what is this? This is a sandwich counter, and this is a fast food thing. People will actually use these lifts to just up and down one floor from the traffic. Traffic is really important. I will be spending quite a lot of time and attention on that in this whole series and in this episode, because it can make or break your build. And as we're talking about traffic, we get to where my build originally started. And I will actually go all the way to the start. We started off with this bit here and this unit here. And the electricity here, which is now a phone box. And then there was a staircase. I think this lift was a staircase, and that was a staircase. And that was all we had. And that's not a lot to begin with. So in the next episode, you'll see me building it up from there. But you're really quite limited with that. So you want to find a route to make money that isn't going to cost too much. And in the beginning, certainly one of the biggest costs that you have is power and other utilities. I will show that this way. Here you can see that we have 5 different utilities, and these cupboards are actually very expensive. What you've got to realize is that in the beginning you can't build very expensive units that bring in a lot of rent, and you start with 10 of these electrical connections, and you'll soon run out of them, because every unit, every small office, which I recommend you actually start the build with, only brings in $100 to $150 a day. So your $250 electrical capacitator or transformer is actually quite expensive. That's already two of your rents every day gone. The other thing that costs rent is these cupboards that make them go up and down, the closets, the wiring closets. They cost 10. Doesn't sound like a lot, but this is a high-rise building, and the higher up you get, the more that actually starts adding to your expenses. So it really pays, even though it isn't possible. Like in Prison Architect, you can use the planning stage to actually plan everything. You can't do that here, but it does really pay before you start to plan out what you want to do where. And that's why I started off with the shopping over there, then the food place, then the offices, which is where we are now, and then on the right hand side we've got some residential as well. And basically I've created four different towers. Now that's because I've got a very large map. You can't do that on a smaller map, but you can sort of mimic the start that I've had, because the first thing I did was simply extend this floor. So this ground floor, we will get rid of the of that. And the ground floor, basically that and the floor above, all became offices. Just added another staircase, no lift to begin with, because if you add a lift, you open yourself up to needing maintenance, and maintenance is a right killer. So yeah, I put my 16 offices in, which was one of the assignments you can get. I've done all my assignments, so I can't show you anymore. But the 16 offices is a good one to start off with, because they're pretty easy to get. They don't cost too much to build. They only need phone and electrics. So a pretty reasonable investment all in all. Once you've got that going, you need to start thinking about other things. So one of the things they want when you get certain offices that want to come, they want food. And these are my two remaining and oldest little food court and cafe things. On the top floor, sort of tucked away, there were two more below them as well. And that was all I needed to get all these offices going. So that also sort of decided where my restaurant was going to be. Then the next step is to actually add a few shops, because that's a contract. Oh, let's do that. I've got auto maintenance, but we'll do that manually anyway. So they went all the way over here. So I already planned, if you like, on the ground level how I wanted everything to be. And I also decided these were staircases as well. You can see this extra layer here. That's because these were all staircases, which are 4 wide. A lift is 3 wide. So you can see the original fabric of the building here, really. Yeah, so that's a good way to start. Don't go too high. If you go, I think it's over 3 floors, people begin to moan that they need to go up too many stairs. So limit all that, but begin your building with putting in lots of little offices, because they don't need many services. They don't need many much in the form of utilities, although they all need a connection, which adds up to the utilities that you've got to have available. And slowly build it up like that. Build up a critical mass, if you like. Once you have done that, you can start to think about the next step. And the next step for me was medium offices. So you can see this was still 2 floors at that point, and I decided I wanted medium offices. And that's when my first lift came in. This one's broken, that's always annoying. That's when my first lift came into the image. And the assignment is for, I think, 12 medium offices. So I built basically 12 stories on top. And you can see a bit of the size of what I've built here by doing this. But yeah, 12 of these different units. And that causes trouble straight away. This is what I call the first wobble. Once you make that sort of extension, you start to need all sorts of services. So these people start moaning about courier services. They will need copy services. They will want IT services. They will want... So before you build that, make sure that you extend down a bit so you can actually place all these services. Because if you don't have the room to place them, and your people are annoyed that they haven't got them there, you either need to drop the rent dramatically, which is not good for your financial situation. And the other thing that might happen is that if they leave, you actually lose prestige. And prestige is very important in the game because it unlocks all the next steps. So you need prestige. Right. The other thing at this point, a lot of people will be tempted, and I was in this Let's Play, you will see, to take a loan because you've used up all your starting money, you're not getting a lot of money in every day, and rather than wait 10 days to get £1,000 or dollars a day, you decide to get a loan. The problem is twofold. One is the more buildings you build, the more your maintenance goes up. The more units you build, the more your maintenance goes up, especially when you haven't planned the traffic right yet. Maintenance is a real killer. You need to be very careful about how much you spend on maintenance. And the other thing is, if you take a loan, you're immediately eating away at your daily income, and then you're stuck to it for 20, 30 turns to pay it back. So I can show you the loans I took. I think Community Bank and Credit Card. 20 turns, 300, 150, that's 450. If you're only making 1,000 a day when your medium offices haven't been filled, for example, that's a big blow. That means that you really slow down the pace of your acceleration. So I would advise not doing that. If you made that mistake, try as soon as you can to get a bigger loan to pay back the older loans, and you know, try and manage costs that way. Because this loan, even though it's longer, is only 400, which is less than 450. This loan, which is the same length, is only 600. You know, you get the point. Right, so it's time to show you the whole build at this point, and I am quite pleased with it. It's still relatively small. I've still got plenty of tiles to do stuff with, but yeah, this is the what I call the basic structure of the building. I've got my shopping block here, which is that high, which is about level 20, which is quite substantial already. I've got restaurants, I've got my posh skybridge, I've got another skybridge, we will get to that in a second, and I've got my residential tower. And the way that this is the most boring looking, I will happily admit, residential tower you can get, but the way I've done it is by putting it away from the rest of it. You can start, if you get it right, with luxury studio apartments. And they only are 6 tiles wide, I think. I've got more in utilities than those tiles, which is 8. But each apartment makes enough money to pay for all these extras. 10, 20, the lift, not the cleaners, the lift is 70. That is another 50, so that's 120. And that's another 50, so that's 180. So every apartment you get actually makes twice as much as the floor's utilities you need. And the contract I got was for 20, so I just went 20 up when I saved up enough money and built 20 of these on top of the first floor, because you can't build them on the ground floor. And that gave me the spine of the rest of my residential. Once I had done that, it was pretty straightforward to add another 20 luxury bedroom apartments, one bedroom apartments. Once I had done that, I could add the fancy two bedrooms. And this is where you start raking in the money, right? My cost for the floor is already covered by this little luxury apartment. So all of a sudden I'm getting another $400 to $420 on top of that. Then I build a luxury next to that, and then upgrade it with another 1,000. And that's how you really need to start thinking when you want to extend your build. And this is also why I recommend you start on this very large floor plan, because that really helps you to achieve that. So yeah, residential block. For the rest of it, there's a few things that I need to talk about. These very big, fancy two-bedroom apartments, they're the largest floor space you can get. They're a bit annoying, because if you put them too close to the elevator, and apparently this is already too close, they don't like it and they will talk. And you know, these elevators are loud and too close. The other thing is, they find foot traffic distracting. Well, they're on the edge of the bloody map, and I don't know what foot traffic they find distracting. Really frustrating. I haven't worked this one out yet, because if you look at, no, I will look at that later. But there's hardly any foot traffic, there's hardly any noise from the elevator. So these are very picky people. And to compensate that, you need to make sure that they are high enough up. And to see that, you need to have the view on. And these posh apartments need quite a bit of green in the view building. So they need to have nice views, because otherwise they get pissed off. So you want to make sure they're on the upper floors. That means, and this is a mistake I made that you'll see in my Let's Play, that the ground floors just need to be large two-bedroom apartments, not the luxury or fancy ones. And actually, they still bring in $800 a day. don't worry about putting in, instead of the fancy two bedroom, putting in large. It's a bit weird because apart from this two bedroom, have I done the same here? Oh, I might have done the same. So these are all standard except for higher up. Oh yeah, that's when I realized that these were a problem, the big ones. So I applied that knowledge to these floors and the top five are luxury and the rest is just normal two bedroom. Right, so that's how I built my residential tower. The other thing that you really need to keep into mind is that these surfaces are not sufficient. I don't know, I haven't got a clue how the game decides how many home cleaners you need for the number of apartments you get. I suspect it might even be one per five apartments, I don't know. I've been adding them forever and it's always just not enough. Is that a big issue? I don't know. It doesn't seem to lead to complaints in the apartments, but I like to have it sorted. So probably if I were to play on with this game, add all that and make sure there's more than enough. The other thing here is tailoring. I've got, 50, maybe 100 residents? Why do 100 residents need two tailors? There's a bit of a balance problem there. But let's not moan too much. So I've shown you the ground bit. Now, this is of course not the nice bit. The nice bit happens up here. And what I've gone for is the Petronas Towers sort of thing. I've not finished the build yet. You can see that I've done my office tower here. This empty space on the side is going to be residential mostly. And yeah, that's just the way I've decided to finish off this build. Really pretty looking, I think. You might think it's horrible. You might think these gaps here underneath this walk bridge are a bit naff. I sort of agree that I might change that up again. But yeah, we wanted height. We wanted to show off how high you can build. We're all the way at the top at the 80th floor. And in here we've got lots and lots of headquarters, which bring in tons of money, but also demand a lot of services like limousine, gentlemen's club or executive club. There's also a helicopter charter, commercial printers. So something to keep in mind. I extended all the medium offices. I've also gone as high as I wanted to in this design with large offices. Large offices again are very demanding as well. That's one of those next sort of hurdles that you will find in the game. Because once you put in large offices, you get all sorts of demands for new services. So all in all, that is my build. And I'm really quite pleased with it. I think it looks ace. I'm still going to go up on the residential because I haven't built any of the big loft apartments. And I want to go there, for example, and there. But that'll come, and you know, I won't make a video on it because all I want to say in this video is already there. So when it comes to tips, I've already discussed that you plan your things so that they're split out over different floors. Each tower should have its own purpose, its own feeling to it, if you like. So office tower, eating. This is why I made this gap, by the way. I put in some more gourmet restaurants here. I might find a different place for them, I'm not sure. And then this is all going to be residential as well. And the shopping tower. Shopping and restaurants are very important to create buzz. I'm swimming in buzz now, I don't need more. But if you want to keep them happy and keep them going, a good tip is to start them off on 50%. And I'm still not charging full whack for them. I could do now because I don't need all the buzz and everything anymore. But it's a very easy way of keeping them happy and making sure you make that buzz, because the buzz is actually very useful, in particular the apartment construction costs and the if you want to build lots of floors, the It's a Steel is very good. You need foot traffic to do the art side of things, and I think for the luxury boutiques and stuff like that. And then there's also the office construction costs. So obviously when you build a tower and extend it and you have to build 12 offices early in the game, they're going to cost a lot of money. Them costing half the money is a very useful thing. So buzz is very important, you want that. The other thing you want is influence. I've not quite worked out how you get influence, but it seems to come from your apartment residents and select offices, and I think it's related to their satisfaction. So as you can see here, my apartments are pretty satisfied except for these money people. And my shops and things are satisfied. And the higher up you get in the office tower, the more satisfied they get. I don't know why they're not satisfied. Oh, they want to be on lower floors. Well, that stuff. You can be where you are. Yeah, so those are things to keep in mind when you build. So divisions, elevators are also very important. And I will talk about that in more detail now. You can see that on the busiest towers, the shopping tower tends to be quite busy on the ground floors. The restaurant towers get really busy at peak time, so dinner time, lunchtime, things like that. They've all got one central shaft. Yeah, so you can see here, I've got this shaft, that shaft with Connie in it, this shaft for the office block, and this shaft for the residential block. That's four. I've actually added a different one here because of aesthetics reasons, and because I want to try one of those other lift type things. But these lift shafts create a lot of traffic on certain floors. And this is what I really want to talk about, is traffic. And traffic is really important to manage. Because if you get too much traffic through certain units in your blocks, then they will actually generate something called grime. And grime isn't very good. The more grime you get, this is pretty obvious stuff really, the more grime you get, the more stuff breaks down, the more that your repair crews or whatever they are called, let me see if I can find one, need to go and fix stuff. And the more they have to go and fix stuff, the more money it costs. And at the moment, even though I've got Automate, I've already got to spend $77.10 to get everything renovated. That can really add up. I made a mistake early on by not managing the traffic well enough and having people walk through a bunch of shops that I put on the ground floor because I thought it would be a handy space to put them. And those shops turned out to need maintenance every other day. And when you need to spend that sort of money on each unit every other day, you're not charging them full rent, you will find that you're actually making a loss on having those shops in your building, and you don't want that. The other thing about traffic is, if you give them these clean hallways, these hallways don't build up grime, right? So the elevators and these clean hallways don't build up grime. So you want to try and make a sort of directional plan for your whole thing. I've got these air bridges because I want people from the offices, where most of my people work, to go into the shopping and food tower easily, because that generates traffic, and my shopping and food towers like traffic because that is how they make money. Okay, what I don't want is traffic in my residential block, because traffic in your residential block creates noise and people don't like noise, so they get annoyed, like you can see with these people who say that all this foot traffic is distracting. So plan your building to do that. This is a very basic structure, I suppose. You could make it a bit more complicated. You could do double height walkways, whatever you want to do, it doesn't really matter. But make sure that you plan your traffic and do that from an early point as well. As you will see in my Let's Play, I've kept traffic in the back of my mind all the way through. Right, the final thing is to always check your utilities. You can really screw up your game if you build 10, 12 new offices and haven't hooked them up and actually find that you need to put in more electrical connections. And there's a bit of a trap there as well. Because you can build the offices, have them hooked up, and if there's nobody living there yet, especially with residentials, you get that sort of clock symbol. When they don't live there, they're not using a connection. So you can have a load of apartments that are empty, they're built, but they're still empty, and think that you've got capacity in utilities, and in actual fact, when people start moving in, you all of a sudden end up losing your utilities. So always keep an eye on this. I always, now that I've got loads of money, I try to keep it well ahead of things. But especially in the beginning, when you don't have a lot of money, you need to worry about every $250 that you spend. Try and make it work. The other thing with the utilities is make sure you upgrade soon enough. Building five of these costs you $1,500 per day. Building and gives you 50 connections. Building one of these costs you half that. It's expensive to build, $2,000. But it costs you half that per day. And making sure that you get that balance right, doing a few sums in your head, really important to making it work. Then there's the really big one. And again, this is more about the upfront build cost. but you go from 50 to 150 for double the price again. It makes electrics a lot cheaper if you can afford to build these units early on. Also, make sure that when you're planning your build, that you try and keep things to a minimum. So you put in the medium officers, those might be the first things that need water. You don't really want to put in lots and lots and lots of water facilities because that's expensive, right? So maybe instead of putting in the medical officers early on, just put in insurance and other things who just need a phone and electricity, and try to balance your build that way so you get enough bang for your buck, if you like, for each dollar you invest. Right, so traffic really important, utilities really important. You will see in my Let's Play, I say this to you and I still muck it up a lot of the time. Aesthetics, this is a bit of a trap I find. Aesthetics are nice in areas where people really appreciate it. So here I've got these luxury shops and they like that there are nice things nearby. It helps with their satisfaction, but they don't pay enough for me to actually do that. And I will show you that. Go away, electrics. This statue is 100 per day, right? So I am giving them a subsidy of 100 per day on a shop that is paying me 600 per day. And they already get the other utilities as well. So you need to be a bit careful with that. If you're going to do that, maybe consider upping their rent. And yeah, it's tricky. It's something that you really want to keep in check. And actually, in terms of the effect on prestige, it could be a way out to get more prestige quickly if you're just one or two prestige behind what you need. But it's expensive. You're throwing 6,000 per art piece, 10,000, 12,000. It's a lot of money to spend. So I wouldn't recommend putting in a lot of money in art and aesthetics. Anything else to talk about? Profitability. Keep an eye on this at all times. So you can see now that my restaurants and things are not making money, which I find quite surprising because they're on that 80% income. So it's saying there's not enough customers. I've just extended these towers recently, especially these gourmet and the luxury stuff, and I think two new department stores. So looking at my build, I've already got a very substantial building, but clearly I've not got enough to make these shops all that happy. So when you extend, make sure you don't just extend the stores and restaurants too quickly, because they will eat at each other and they will make things more difficult. There might be a way to make that different with a critical mass thing, but I'm not sure it works. So for example, having a big shopping mall that's focused on shopping might work a bit different. I might have to do that in a different playthrough, see if that works out. So I think that shows off my build. I think I've given you an awful lot of tips in this video already. What I would like you to do now is leave me a like and subscribe if this video was useful for you. If you didn't find it useful, just drop a dislike so I know you didn't think it was useful. If you want to know anything else in specific, ask me and I will try and make a video about that at some point. And if you want to, go and see the rest of the episodes. They'll be uploaded quite soon, today and tomorrow. And hopefully this was useful for you. My name is Dr. Klumber. I appreciate that you've watched this video. And I hope to see you for another Let's Play in the future. Who knows what I'll be playing next? I don't know. You don't know. That makes the show. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.